All right, what are we going to be doing this morning?
Well, this morning I'm going to be taking my last turtles that I hatched out the shell. What I do there, I take them out of the shell, put them in here to start washing themselves, and I throw away the shell, then I look for the cold turtles. That means the turtles that either have black spots or something that I can't really sell.
Okay, what's that rag you just took off over here there? Well, you put that on top of your container?
Yeah, you see we have holes right here to allow air to go in, and like that, because the egg needs air to breathe. This is to keep the bugs out, because even though we keep our building clean, you know, there's always bugs in the air, but I keep the bugs out, so that's what keeps the bugs out of air and also gives it air. And this keeps the turtles inside the little basket until we get to take them out.
Okay, how about the humidity? Because I remember, because, you know, I'm your brother, I worked on the pond. That also keep the humidity down, like the moisture from going, evaporating too fast,
right?
Or something?
Oh yeah, it keeps the moisture. When we put a little bit of water at the bottom of the container, not the way it touches the egg, but at the bottom, and this helps keep the moisture in, and when it's starting to hatch, it builds up a lot of heat. That's why these holes are here too. When it's starting to hatch at about 5 weeks old that the eggs have been picked up, they start hatching at about 6 weeks. So about a month after we pick them up, I put a fan circulating on them to where it takes the excess heat out. I usually hatch them at about 83, 84 degrees, but it still builds up to maybe 90, 95 degrees in here. That's why we got to watch the temperature. So that temperature key stays down with the fan circulating on it. And when you go see this is a pretty good hatch over here. So that's all the baby turtles. That's how they are with the shell. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pick them up, put them in the water. Okay. They're going to start bathing themselves.
It looked like they hatched pretty good right there.
Yeah, they hatched pretty good. Now, we did go through the eggs. After a month we pick them up, we go through the eggs and take out the ones that won't hatch. They do have eggs that aren't fertile, especially since Hurricane Katrina and Gustav passed. We lost a lot of our turtles. I don't know if it was saltwater intrusion, and I think we lost a lot of males. So we added some males this year to try to bring our hatch rate up. And when Daddy had the farm, we used to hatch like about 90%. And this year it went down to very small, maybe 80%. So I'm trying to bring my hatch rate up. It's going to make it a little bit better for next year.
So what you doing there? You put them in the water. I see that water getting kind of dirty.
Yeah.
So it kind of cleans them out and you just rinse them out a couple of times?
Right. See all the shells start breaking up and it goes on the turtle. So that rinses them out and cleans them up. And then I let them swim for just a couple of minutes. Then I'll put them in another container of water to get them really clean, and then I'll pack them back in here, but a double deck or something about that high, and I'll put 125 per container. And the reason we put that many per container is because turtle needs moisture, just like in the wild. Like in the farm, when they lay their eggs, the eggs are one on top of each other. There's about 15 eggs in a hole, no bigger than this at the top, no deeper than that, and no wider than that in the hole. There's 15 eggs, sometimes 18 to 21 eggs. So the reason that is, it keeps the moisture inside that nest. And it keeps heat from the beginning, at the beginning when you need it. Now once it's hatched, some of them stay in there till the next spring. I've seen myself get the farm ready for the turtles to lay, and I've seen little turtles come out the ground. And that was some that was laid the year before. So some come out right away, but some of them actually stay in there the whole summer and pass the winter in there. Now this is where we find our two-headed sometimes. Last time I took some out, I found a two-headed. Now she was a little weak, so we're gonna get somebody that's gonna take real good care of her to where she can pick up and live. But some of them, the first two that we had were very strong. I see they're swimming around, and that's normal because I'm gonna take them out in a few minutes and put them in a little bit bigger container to where they have a little bit more place. I see this one right here. This was not a perfectly formed turtle, so I'll put this one on the side. And I'm going to feed this one a little bit to try to bring it up to where it starts picking up strength.
Right. It's kind of like body heat. If you're in the cold, two people together puts up body heat. Now, what these turtles over here, with your experience, you realize that and recognize, comparing with the wild, it keeps the heat, the moisture, the humidity. It's just a better way to keep the turtles, not like one turtle by himself.
Right. One turtle by itself, we've seen that in a while. Also, that one turtle by itself loses its moisture, and during the winter, it's going to freeze. But during the winter, they have the heat from each one of them that keeps them warm. So See, this is the, now see, these hatch pretty good, but like I said, we took some out, it's just one egg that didn't hatch. We had taken some out earlier. And you see at the bottom all the water? What happens there is we put a little bit of water, but when they start hatching, it builds up the humidity because we have the temperature a little high. And when it gets a little bit, temperature rises, it builds up that moisture inside. You see how pretty it makes that turtle.
Right.
Now I'll put this one on the side, let it moisture just a few minutes while I take the next one out. I'll be right back.